On new COVID developments tonight, the federal government's website to get free test kits is up and running. It's covidtests.gov. Also, word from the CDC that 3/4 of the U.S. population has gotten at least one vaccine dose. Progress, certainly, but still short of many other parts of the world. Meantime, New York State, where the latest surge hit early, is now showing signs of a steep decline in cases. Much the same across the Northeast. Not yet the case in much of the country, however. On the school front, there's some new data points. An overview of 36 studies in 11 countries published in JAMA Pediatrics finding consistent negative health effects of school closings on kids, which especially when it comes to kids' mental health. Also today, the American Academy of Pediatrics reporting new childhood cases rose 69% last week. Hospitalizations held steady. Now, with all that on the table, there's also the case of Virginia's new governor, Glenn Youngkin. On Saturday, his first day in office, he rescinded the Commonwealth's K-12 mask mandate. And in some schools, that's not been welcome. Gary Tuchman went to Virginia and filed this report.
10 minutes away from the Virginia State Capitol building, where new governor Glenn Youngkin was inaugurated this past weekend, is Richmond's Westover Hills Elementary School, where an executive order he issued is getting panned.
We will be maintaining our mask mandate.
Jason Camras is the superintendent of Richmond's 55 public schools. Here in Richmond and a number of other school districts across the state, there's concern that without mask mandates, the spike in COVID cases will only get worse. Anna Mason is the mother of a second grade daughter at the Westover Hills School. She says despite her superintendent's stance, the governor's order, which takes effect next Monday, is very concerning.
I feel really disappointed.
Why? Yeah.
Because I'm scared. I'm scared for my kid. I'm scared for her classmates. Yeah, and I feel like this is, what other protection do we have?
Dion McCormick is the mother of a fourth grader.
Your school district says, we're not listening to the governor.
Right.
We want our kids in our school to still wear their masks. How do you feel about that?
I feel like they're protecting us. They're protecting our kids. I love it.
Notably, one of the governor's children goes to a private out-of-state high school that does have a mask mandate. We wanted to ask the governor about that and about school districts in his state defying his order, but our request to speak with him was declined. However, his spokesperson did send us a statement saying, the governor is allowing Virginians to opt out of the mask mandates so that parents can choose what's best for their children. Over the weekend, the governor did say on camera that school districts need to listen to parents.
Because we will use every resource within the governor's authority to explore what we can do and will do in order to make sure that parents' rights are protected.
And he does indeed get some support from parents at the Richmond school.
It still should be a choice. Nobody should be able to be forced to do anything.
So you agree with the governor?
Yes.
Robin Sneed is the grandmother of a second grader.
I know what it feels like for me to have a mask on, and it's hard for me to breathe. So I can only imagine how they feel. The children.
But at this school, a majority of parents we talk to feel differently.
Governor says that should be up to the parent. It shouldn't be up to the schools. Parents should make the decisions for their own children. Your reaction?
I don't know if I agree with that because their decisions affect my child.
It's not clear what Governor Youngkin can do, wants to do, or will do when it comes to school districts that disobey his executive order. Either way, though, this district shows no signs of backing down.
Are you concerned your school district could be punished by the governor for not listening to what he's saying?
I think we'll have to take it day by day. And of course, if there are any repercussions, we will do our very best to defend ourselves and to continue forward with what we believe is right.
This parent agrees with that plan of action.
Because I think I care about everyone and we're responsible for everyone.
So everyone should be responsible for each other.
Exactly, Boo.
Gary joins us now from Richmond. So you're outside a school board meeting. I take it they'll be discussing this issue?
They just discussed it, Anderson, and they passed a resolution endorsing the decision made by their superintendent. I can tell you there are a number of districts around this state that either say we're sticking with the mask mandate or still considering it. And private schools are part of this, too. The order affects private schools. I talked to a spokesperson for the diocese here. The diocese, the Catholic diocese, has about 30 schools. It's a very large diocese, Richmond, and they are maintaining the mask mandate right now. However, they say they will seek guidance from the Virginia Department of Health. They will review the governor's order and then announce if they're going to make any change before the deadline day when this all takes effect. this coming Monday.
Anderson. Gary, appreciate it. Thanks very much.